Hello, everyone. Thanks for tuning in again. Now, it wasn't long ago, it might have been last week, and I was complaining that I didn't have Google Home routines. And what happened was there was a number of people who did have Google Home routines who gave me some hints and some clues that tuned me into the fact that just plain old my Android tablet had not updated the Google Assistant application. And so I went out, I found an update, and I installed that, and I now have Google Home routine. So I'm able to take you through a full demo here today, thanks to all of you. So let me show you some of the best ways to set up Google Home routines, and of course, Google Home's custom scheduled routines. All right, let's get started with Google Home routines. And what I'm going to tell you right off the bat is that on an iPhone, you cannot get routines to work. If you're using an Android phone or tablet, this will work. So start there. Head into your Google Home application, go into more settings, and scroll down the list here. And if you see the word routines here instead of my day, you now have routines, you have access to it. Now, what you're going to notice right off the bat is that lots of those routines up at the top were actually your shortcuts in the previous version of the application. So let me go into one here and show you. You can actually edit the custom command if you want, what you were having the Google Home do based on your shortcut. So I would say keep your stick on the ice or show me hockey, and it would show me hockey videos on YouTube. I just added on Basement Chrome, which is one of my Chromecast devices in my home. Now you can see Make It Light is another shortcut. It used to say turn on basement lights. With the new contextual control of lights, I'm going to say turn on all lights. And you can see you can save up top right, or you can simply exit the routine and it will ask you if you'd like to save it. Now, here are some of the ready-made routines down at the bottom of this list here. And these are ones that Google has already created and you can use right off the bat. So I'm going to go into Good Morning. And once I'm in Good Morning, you can see I can say Good Morning or tell me about my day. Or there's a number of other things you can say to the Google Home here. I can set my ringer and notification volume, but what's important to notice about that is that it only works on an Android phone. So again, this is not going to work on an iPhone. Moving down, you can see you put a check mark next to taking the phone off silent, and it will do that. And then you can also put a check mark next to adjusting lights, plugs, and more. So this is a list from your home control, the portion of the app that has home control in it. And you can see you can turn on, turn off, or leave the device in the state it currently is. And remember, this is all when you say good morning to your Google Home. Now, if I had a smart thermostat in the home that was connected to my Google Home application, I could adjust it. I can also use all the different scenes that have come in from devices like Philips Hue or other smart home light systems. Then I can turn on or off the weather, information about my commute, my calendar, today's reminders. I can adjust the media volume if I'd like. And I can also hit the add action button, which allows me to basically type in any custom action that I'd like through my Google Assistant. And then I can choose to play music. Now, you can use the default music service, or you can write a whole command here for what type of music you'd like to play. On top of that, you also have access to news, radio, podcasts, an audiobook, and of course, you can choose to play nothing after you've said good morning to your Google Home. Now, once you've done all that, you can also change the order that all of this occurs in. And this will feel very similar to some of the past functionality that we had from our Google Home. You can simply drag the items up and down. This is just like the old My Day functionality. Now, once you're done everything, you click the check mark top right, and you can see that the good morning routine now has 7 actions and it is fully enabled. Next up, what I want to show you is how to create a custom routine. Now, you click the plus in the bottom right, and you can either add commands and or you can add a time that things trigger at. So this is the scheduled routines capability. So I'm going to choose start the weekend as my command. I'm also going to add in a second command. Let's start the weekend. Now, that will give me a couple things, a couple options to say, and then you can see where I can set a time and day. So I'm going to choose Friday at 5:30. That's kind of when I'm going to get home from work most days. So I'm going to set it for 5:30. Click OK. And this is on Friday afternoon. And then you choose the speaker that all of this is going to trigger off of. You can also choose to get notified on your phone when this happens. So now I'm going to add an action, and I could add a Google Assistant command, or I could choose from a very similar popular actions list like the one we just chose from. So I could head in, I could adjust my lights, my plugs, all of those devices. Now I do have a Philips Hue Bloom light that I'm going to turn on. And then I could choose a scene if I had a scene kind of already created with maybe rotating my color lights or something to that effect. Now, on top of the actions you saw before, you could broadcast that you're home, you can send text messages, and you could also read text messages. Now, you can put a number in here, or you can leave it blank, and you will be prompted for a number when the routine runs. And I could just say, happy weekend here on that text message, and it will actually go out at that time, and you'll be prompted for it. Now, of course, I could adjust the media volume. I could put my phone on silent, or take the phone off of silent. And you do have to put check marks next to anything you want to have trigger. I could also ask the Google Home to say something at the end of my routine. So I could say, hooray, it's the weekend. And the Google Home will actually say that here. But I do have to hit add up in the top right to have that occur. Once I hit add, you can see the new routine starting to come together here. You can see when it's going to trigger, and this is what my assistant should do. And then, of course, if I wanted, I could continue to add actions, or I can add media playing. So I could add the music, radio, podcasts, all the same stuff all over again. And you can choose to play any type of music or any type of radio station. If you want to play by a genre, an artist, a playlist, all of those things can occur. So I'm just going to turn on the radio here. We're not quite starting a party, but we're starting the weekend. So we'll start the radio up at 5:30. And then now you can see the full custom routine. It's a custom scheduled routine, or a routine that I can trigger using my voice. So let's get a little bit deeper here. And what I'm going to tell you is I have a Harmony hub attached to my Google Home. It's in my home, and I'm going to add a command here to go ahead and trigger my TV on, and then I'm going to create one to turn off. So you can see I'm adding the different commands here. This is all being done in a custom routine. And once I'm done adding those commands, I can also trigger this at a given time if I'd like. Now, when I go into the popular actions for this custom routine, you notice there's no access to a Harmony hub. Or what I'll tell you is there's no access to the Harmony hub. So I have to do this a bit of a different way. And this is similar to the way shortcuts used to work within the Google Home application. So, and here's where I can add an action, and I can directly type in what I want it to do. So I want to ask Harmony to turn on the TV. I can't actually choose to do this by a media route. There's no way to turn on video just yet. I assume that's going to come with the smart displays here. But ultimately, that's all I have to do to actually have a routine that triggers my TV on once I have those items set up in the Harmony Hub application. So do keep in mind, I have my Harmony Hub fully set up. Now, what's interesting about this is if you go away on vacation and you want your TV to trigger on at a certain time, or you want a device to turn on at a certain time, you can actually do that. So I can choose the days, the time, and I can choose which speaker is going to do it. Now, obviously here, this, it doesn't matter which speaker does this because nothing's going to be said, but I'm going to trigger it on at 9 a.m. for all of those days while I'm gone. And obviously once I return from my trip, I'm going to change the settings for this routine. Now, as I said, I have to set up a TV off command. And once again, if I set a time and day to trigger this off, then, you know, I'm going to set here 10:30. So for an hour and a half, my TV will be on in my home every day. And maybe that's how I feel secure here when I've left my home for a week or so. So let's go ahead and I'll show you a couple of demos here. Just show you that what I have set up today does work.
Hey Google.
Good morning.
Hi, Brian. I'm sorry, but I can't take your phone off silent from Google Home. It is 12:33 a.m. Right now in New York City, it's 79 and clear. Today, it'll be sunny, with a forecasted high of 91 and a low of 73. Have a great day.
Jimmy Eat World took control of what they needed to do and self-financed.
Hey Google.
TV time.
All right, getting Harmony.
Turning on TV.
Hey Google.
TV off.
Turning off TV.
Hey Google.
Start the weekend.
Hooray, it's the weekend.
From the 340s.
Start your home buying journey with Homes by Abby.
So there you go, guys. That's everything around Google Home's routines that I want to show you today. It's quite the application already. I'm sure we're going to see it expand over time, but it's an excellent, excellent addition to the Google Home application, and it gives you your first true opportunity for automation through your Google Home. So thanks for watching, everyone. We'll see you next time.